from this to this. My Bill Cipher dress is the latest costume I've created where I've used my own design. Sometimes I use my own original ideas, such as when I created my Christmas craft elf. Other times I do my own take on characters, like when I did Wendy from Gravity Falls, but with a summer, vintagey feel. It's really fun to come up with ideas, design something, and then create it. In this video, I'm going to go through the process I went through to design and create my Bill Cipher dress. First thing, inspiration. We were rewatching Gravity Falls, and despite Bill Cipher being, spoiler alert, he's a villain, he's a fun character. And despite being a triangle, he's full of dimension and interest. But he's a triangle, and I'm not. To start off the process, I like to gather reference pictures. What am I starting from? What does the character look like? What are the key components? What are the elements of their outfit? So I gather all these up. I usually use Google or Pinterest, but screen caps from the source is also really handy. Yeah, he's just a triangle. Arms, leg, a bow tie, one eye, and a fun top hat. Sometimes he has a cane. Then I look at what other people have created. Yeah, I look through Google and Pinterest, but also on cosplay.com. I'm not likely to recreate what somebody else has done. I already had ideas percolating in the back of my mind what I wanted to do, but it's really nice to see what somebody else has created. Sometimes going from a flat image to an actual three-dimensional physical costume is really hard, especially with Bill Cipher. He doesn't wear clothes. It's one thing to take a cartoon character, take the elements of their clothing and recreate it. But with a non-human character, especially one not wearing clothes, it's a little harder to create something wearable. This presents challenge to the costume creator. It's nice to see how other people have tackled those challenges to give ideas how I want to represent the character. Then I create a folder of images. I'll grab some reference pictures, some images of what other people have cosplayed, fan art sometimes, and if I have an idea of what pattern I want to use, I'll grab an image of the cover of the pattern and put that in the folder as well. For Bill Cipher, I was pretty sure I wanted to use Simplicity 8127. Then I let it sit for a while. I'll look through it periodically. Sometimes I'll search for more images to add in, especially if I want to get like the back of a costume and I'm like, oh, I don't really have an image for that. Oh, I want to see this angle. What is the pattern in this part? I may search through my stash of patterns to come up with ideas or inspiration. When I'm really ready to solidify the design, I go through the images again, really focusing on the elements that I like and why I like them. Let's go through the images I had for Bill Cipher, and I'll tell you about my thought process for each of these images. Different. I mean, it's good, but it's not the aesthetic I wanted. I like the eye, though, how crisp and clear it is. That helps convey the character. Oh, now this has some of the design elements that I wanted. Brick pattern at the bottom of the skirt, black stockings, long black gloves, bow, the eye, top hat, cute blonde wig. But I don't like how the sleeves kind of ruin the illusion of the triangle by drawing the eye back out. I really wanted this to look like a triangle. That's what Bill Cipher is. Super cute. I like the poof of the skirt. Not sure what's happening at the bottom there, if it's lace or a petticoat sticking out. No, I think I'll keep my hem very simple. This may not be my favorite, but I like the design choice of incorporating the eye into the bodice of the dress. Very cool. I also love that she did the brick pattern in gold, like in the show. That's definitely something I wanted to do, that little level of accuracy. I think this is one of my favorites. Has a lot of the elements there, the black gloves, stockings, very nice top hat, cute wig, but I'm not a fan of the vest on Bill Cipher. Don't get me wrong, I love a good vest and I own several, but it's not in line with my image of what I wanted for Bill Cipher. Very clean, simple, just what he has in the show. With all of these elements rattling around in my brain, it was time to sketch. Usually I use a fashion croquis as a base to draw upon, because I admit I'm not a great artist. It's nice to have some kind of shape to draw upon. But I was looking at the line art for the pattern, and boom, I had this. And I knew what other elements I wanted. What wig, gloves, stockings. I even knew what pair of shoes I own that I wanted to use. Next steps were to find material and do the prep work before I could sew. I used a flat sheet that I found at a thrift store. Beautiful color yellow. Didn't think I was gonna find that. I took my measurements, figured out what size that corresponds to on the pattern, then what pattern pieces I needed for this dress, read the instructions. Oh, there are a few pieces I don't need to cut out since I'm not putting in those eyelets. Then I followed the directions and made the dress. This is one of the few items where I mostly followed the directions instead of having to adapt like crazy to fit me or the character, mostly. Being confined at home due to the pandemic, I couldn't go out and get a longer zipper, but I managed. I put my zipper that I did have at the skirt and then used snaps for the bodice closure. Making the bow was really straightforward. I used Simplicity 2525. Sure, I probably could have just winged it. I've made bows before, but since I had a pattern, I figured, why not? Brick design at the bottom of the skirt. I studied the reference pictures from the show to get an idea of what the brick pattern is like. Since I wasn't recreating every detail, I wasn't as fussed about having it be exactly like what was in the show, but I did make each brick layer longer as I went down the skirt, like in the show. I stitched the gold ribbon on by hand. The eye was a bit more work. I measured the proportions of the eye from an image. I sketched it out on paper the size I wanted. Tested how that looked on the dress. Not bad. I used that paper as a pattern piece. I cut out the white material a little larger because I put black ribbon around the outside of it. For the eyelashes, I used the same ribbon, but put pipe cleaner in to give them structure to stand on their own. I already had a fun
black top hat that I found at a thrift store. The gloves were also a thrift store find. The wig is one of the first I bought when I started cosplaying. The shoes are just a pair of Oxfords that I've had for years. And then long black socks.
Even though there aren't any cons to go to, I like having another light summer costume to wear so I won't be dying of the heat when I can go back to cons. I specifically only basted on the eye and made the bow as a removable pin. I wanted the versatility to be able to wear this just as a fun summer dress. Well, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you'd like to see more, click that subscribe button. Until next time, have fun and be creative. Focus, focus on me. You focused on me? Good. I hope. What was it? That one. My go-to shot. When in doubt. Me. I'm here. I'm lovely. I can't believe I said that. Okay, camera, focus on me. Good? Got it? Yay.